Hi guys. Oh wow, my voice just cracked. Sorry again. Lost my train of thought again. Hi guys. So it's Tiffany, and we're back with another. Well, I'm back with another video. It's actually been a really long time since we filmed anything at all. So yeah, but I'm guessing you guys saw Brittany's video already about where she's going to college and how she came to that decision. So she said she wanted me to make a video of my own, and so here it is. Right, so right now I'm actually wearing my college hoodie, but I'm gonna keep it a surprise until the end, even though most of you might already know where I'm going, but if you don't, then stay tuned. But anyway, here we go. Okay, so my entire college admissions process was kind of, how do I say this? Like, it was not hard, but it wasn't easy exactly either. So obviously, like, I applied to like a bunch of different schools. I actually applied to only like six. I think originally I was planning to do seven. No, I think I did seven. And then originally I was planning to do eight. But the one I took off was Stony Brook because I figured it didn't really have the program I was looking for. So I decided not to, like, you know, waste money on the college app and just, you know, take it out of my list. For those of you who don't know, I'm planning to major in pharmacy. So I was looking for schools with a PharmD program, and the PharmD program is a 6-year program that, like, after you study 6 years, you get your, like, it's like a, almost like a doctorate degree, but not quite. It's, like, apparently after you get this degree, like, you're basically a doctor of pharmacy. So, what happens is, for your first 2 years, you take your PP1 year and your PP2 year, you take like your prerequisite courses, which are like basic undergrad courses. But then once you hit your third year, which is your P1 year, that's your professional, that's your first professional year, and that's when you start getting into like the actual pharmacy, like study the intro to pharmacy, and then you study like actual medicine and stuff like that. So yeah. And then your final two, I think, or final year itself is just gonna be like all experience based. So you just kind of go out there, and the school will send you to wherever, like, hospitals are that they send their students to, and then you kind of just work there and you learn from actual pharmacists until you graduate. And then after you graduate, then I just have to take the test, the PCAT, which is the pharmacy CAT, and I would have to get my license. Of course, for me, it's gonna be a little more complicated because of where I'm deciding to go to school, but that'll come in a little bit. So, because I applied to so many different schools, well, not that many, but because I applied to so many different schools with the PharmD program, right? So what happened was I got into every single one of them, which I'm really proud of, and I'm really happy that all the schools actually decided to accept me because I didn't think I was going to do that well. But my top two choices were my dream school, which was, well, my dream school because I didn't really have a dream school, but it was my favorite out of all the seven I applied to, I think, and that was Northeastern University in Boston. And my second choice was Rutgers University, which is a state university of New Jersey. So my first choice was Northeastern because there are two things that I actually really want to do while I'm studying in college, and one of them is to study abroad, and the second thing is to, like, go away to study. So in terms of Rutgers and Northeastern, I would actually be away from home anyway for both schools, so like that already took off like one of the checkpoints for me. In terms of studying abroad, so what happens is in Rutgers, if I do the pharmacy program, I wouldn't be able to. So that was kind of already like a, I don't really know what I should do about that. But Northeastern offered me an opportunity. They have a program called the NUIN program, which is a really cool program that sends you, I think I just showed you my slider. I'm gonna pretend you didn't see that. I'm gonna cover this. So, where was I? Right, but my other choice was Northeastern, and Northeastern offered me acceptance into their NUIN program, which is a study abroad program. So what they do is they send me abroad to a location that I would choose, and I would study there for, I think, my first semester, which would be the fall semester, fall of 2018. And then in spring 2019, the second semester of my first year, I would come back to Boston and then continue my studies there. Unfortunately, Northeastern didn't work out for me because of the financial stuff. The financial situation was very, very dangerous, to say the least, because it was a lot of money, and I didn't really want to put my parents to go through that and having to pay that, because it was basically me paying for everything, and I would get zero aid, and just it would definitely take a toll on our family. So I didn't want that to happen. And even if they were willing to pay for it, which I think they would if I really insisted on it, but I didn't want to put them through that, number one. And second of all, when I graduated, I would have, like, it would have racked up to be like maybe about $500,000 worth of student debt. So I did not want to go through that myself either. So I was off the list. So because of that, I have decided to go to Rutgers. Oh well, Rutgers, can you see? There's Rutgers with the R. In Rutgers, they offered me a seat in their six-year PharmD program, which is just me straight studying for 6 years, and then I graduate and I'm out. But like I said, they didn't offer a study abroad program. But what happened was I ended up being accepted into the Honors College in Rutgers University. And in the Honors College, I would get a chance to go abroad. Maybe not for a whole semester, but what happens is like there are classes that we take, and occasionally they will send us maybe on like a 10-day or like 2-week trip to like somewhere foreign, like a foreign country, somewhere abroad. It was supposed to be like a service trip, I think. But that would have been my chance to like study abroad. And honestly, I feel like this is actually a much better fit for me because it is my first time away from my family. It's my first time away from home. And even though I really, really, really wanted that experience, I like had this kind of like worrying feeling, like if it was too far, what would I do if I really did get homesick? What would I do if like something really went wrong? Or like just me being out there on my own, like it's scary first of all, and if I really can't handle it, then it would be bad because I would have to put myself through it for like the next half a year. So I think these kind of like little trips in Rutgers University, like with the seminars and all the other classes that I take, I think these trips are actually a much better fit for me. I'm actually really happy with where I'm going. And I actually visited the campus already for like some sort of, not some sort of, it was like a student acceptance day. And so I went there and like we explored like the dormitories. And for my first year, I have to live in the Honors College with the other Honors students and some of the faculty and stuff. So from what I saw, it's actually really nice. The building was only recently, like, I think they recently remodeled it or something, I don't remember, but It's actually really pretty. It's like all like modern style, and I really like that. The dorms are nice, and I actually got myself a roommate already, even though I know nobody from New Jersey, but we've been like talking, trying to get to know each other, so I'm actually really excited, and I hope I get to make really good friends with the people that I meet at the Honors College. Well, yeah, I think I've found my match, and I'm actually really excited to be going to college in Rutgers this year. Wow, my god, it's gonna be at the end of this year. Yeah, so fall 2018, I'm gonna be in New Brunswick, New Jersey. No, I can't talk today. Yeah, so I'm just really excited, and I hope I do really well. And I hope everybody watching also does really well if you're looking into colleges, or if you're going to college soon like I am, then I wish you the best of luck. Oh my god, I can't believe senior year is almost over. Oh my goodness. Like Brittany said, I think she said we were gonna do some like other challenge videos or something. Yeah, she said there was like the Instagram recreating there's a challenge where you recreate Instagrams of other people. And we've been looking into photos that we can recreate. There's also the ugly location photo shoot challenge, which I think would be really fun, but we definitely need more time. So yeah, everybody out there, best of luck no matter what you're doing and where you're going. I hope you guys have a nice day, nice night, whatever time it is. I just hope you have a nice experience. Yeah. Good night! Thanks for watching! Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment!